Bada 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 bada. Am I pronouncing your name right?
Toza.
Toza. Right, okay, Rachel Toza. Who do you support?
Chelsea!
Chelsea!
Stop it. All right, what do you do for a living?
I'm a PA for Sinclair Properties.
Oh, and what do they do?
They're property developers.
Ah, do you like property?
Love it. Like a big swanky one.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh. I've got a semi. Well, I have. Okay. What is your marital status?
Single.
Do you have a boyfriend?
I do.
No. What's his name?
His name's Alex.
And how long have you been going out with him for?
About a year and a half.
He'll never last. And what does Alex do for a living?
Alex works at M&C Saatchi Advertising.
Oh, I met him. Yeah, he said. I met him. He said to me, "There's 3 points to advertising. One is you have to grab attention, and I can't remember the other two because I found him quite dull."
He said, "I'm very creative." You know? Yes. Oh, it's too orangey for the crows. Oh. Just say HSA. That's what it's Oh, it's great, he was.
Okay, do you have a tattoo?
No, I don't.
You don't? Have you ever had any body markings?
No.
No, I'll give you one. 4 out of 10. Woman! Hey! Ooh!
Ooh!
Ooh! Morning, David Dunn. Ooh! Oh, my God. What bad luck for? All right, I'll give you 6. I'll give you 10.
Thank you.
All right, interesting fact is?
Oh, my dad made the teeth for Jaws in the James Bond films. Like the man with
the metal teeth.
The metal teeth.
That's amazing. Do you like James Bond?
Love him.
All right, you like spies. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right, good. And do you know any?
No.
Ah, they're good spies then. But I tell you what, I shouldn't really tell you this, but before I was an international TV personality, I was in fact a spy.
No, you
Well, when I say a spy, I wasn't actually officially doing business, but I did work for the KGB. I didn't actually work for the KGB, but I played football for the KGB. Oh. I played football for them because they needed a good striker, and I sort of stepped in there. And we played against the CIA, right? And there was 88 minutes gone on the... What? What are you doing that for? Stop it. It was 98 minutes on the clock, and it was 0-0. But fortunately, we won with a defection. Oh, Rachel, please could you show the readers out there what they can win in our quality game, Feed the Iron Curtain. Yeah! Right, you ready to catwalk? Okay, cue the music, please. Fantastic pair. We looked walking up and down the catwalk there. Obviously you're a pro and I'm a pro, but these guys here are amateurs. Could you pick an Amma to walk with us?
On the end then.
Ah. Right, old knees up, right, old knees up. Cue the music, please. Well done, brilliant. Right. Might use my kung fu. Right, now, if you want to be a Soccer M Soccerette this season, send us a photo, a letter, and make sure you put your phone number on it. Please put your phone number on it so we can phone you. Here is the address. The address is Soccer M, PO Box 11, Ittersworth, Middlesex, TW75PQ. Email us, as always, soccerm at bsky.com. OK. Rachel, if you'd like to take a seat now, please. Shall I?
Please,
shall I? I'll get the card out. Come on, I'll get the card out.
Morning, Ruddock.
Oh, they're soccer men. Oh, yeah. Lovely lady, eh, Ginger?
Draw! Yeah. Come on, soccer men, you know a little bit about James Bond, apparently, old girl. Well, Lovejoy, apparently, James Bond is really popular these days. We went to a convention the other day, Ginger, right? And we met them
you
all.
You apparently went to a convention, or you went to a convention?
No, we definitely went to a convention. Okay. Apparently, it's very popular.
Oh, right.
So we met
all
the characters there. We met 007.
Right.
We met Moneypenny.
Right.
We even met M.
What was Q like?
Right round the block, oh boy. Like I said, really, really popular. No, but we actually did meet 007 there. We met the great Sean Connery. Oh. So I thought I'd do you a favour and get a decent guest on the show for a while. Instead of all these losers on the sofa. So, I said to him, Connery, how would you like to come on our show? He says, well, I'll do that. What time do I need to come along? So I said, how about ten-ish? And he says, ten-ish? I haven't even got my racket.
No, it was a gag. It was Roger Moore, and he says your show sticks.
Oh. Anyway, in the papers this week, did you see Atomic Kitten, old boy? Ooh. Atomic Kitten, they're singing at, yes, just right at what they look like. They're singing at the Champions League. I tell you what, old boy, they aren't half bad.
Really? What? Half bad?
No, they aren't half bad, they're all bad. Hey! That guy comes courtesy of the Muppet Show. Hey, Jim. Right, old boy. Yeah, all right. I see you got on the sofa today. Oh, Burgess. Hey. Morning, old boy. You know, Lovejoy spends a lot of time in the States.
Yeah, California, apparently.
No, the States. Drunk, really drunk, very, very drunk, unconscious, and just about ready to write the new album. Excellent state. And also there, look, it's our old sparring partner, Ruddock. Morning, old boy.
Yeah.
Morning.
Go on, I'm waiting, Rick.
Now, Ruddock, they tell us you're going to be appearing on a big screen. I didn't know they made screens that big. Come on! Bring out a wide screen! Is it IMAX? Is it Panavision? I don't know. Who's your feeder, Ruddock? Come on, bring it on! Anyway, Lovejoy, we're off the top scrap. That's it. Go on, Ruddock, it's not like you to turn food down. Go on. Anyway, we're off for lashing of ginger beer. Come on, Ginger.
I'm sorry, Razor. I'm sorry. I know nothing about that. Right, British summertime. Brilliant. Yeah. British summertime starts officially tomorrow, which means this lot have turned up. Morning. What are you looking for?
It's a big nature reserve in Devon.
Exmoor.
I know, I've tried creams, ointments, the lot. I just can't shift it.
Would you like a coffee?
No, I'm all right, thank you.
Well, we're very excited. Summertime's here, we're off camping. We arrived at the colony last night. I've got a brand new tent, but it was very windy and I was struggling with it.
Oh, did you eventually get it up?
Yes, but it was long after midnight and Jennifer was getting tired.
Would you like a coffee?
No, I'm all right.
Oh, Tim, you should see where we've pitched the tent, though. It really is so picturesque. Just near a little pond, we went down there this morning, and as we went in the water there was a beautiful young girl, I must say, blonde hair, beautiful figure. She was bathing in the water.
Oh, were you washing?
No, but Geoffrey was.
Hey, speaking about ponds, you like swimming, don't you? Have you raced Betty again recently?
Yes, we had a race just last week, actually. And as always, I gave her a length.
Did you win?
Only just. She's improved beyond all measure. She's got very strong arms, very strong legs, and very impressive breath.
Would you like a coffee?
No, I'm all right. Oh, how's little Dick?
Ah, little Dick. He's in love. He's got an admirer, Sue.
Oh.
Sue chases him around all around the campsite, along the meadow, and everywhere. Yesterday, they were playing softball. Little Dick was batting, and as he hit the ball, she chased after him, and they fell over in a heap.
Oh, did he get to first base?
No.
It was quite pathetic to watch, actually. We think he'll be batting for the other side soon.
How are you?
I'm OK, thanks,
Tim. What are you up to at the moment?
Well, I've just got a job in a library. I love books, as you know, and I'm looking after the politics section.
Oh, right. Have you read Marx?
Yes, but that's from the Wicker Chairs.
Yay!
What are you reading there?
This, Tim, this is the business section out of the newspaper. I've saved up all my pocket money and I've put it into shares. But with all the troubles in the world at the moment, I'm worried about the fluctuation of prices. Do you want to have a look?
No. Have they dropped?
No.
No. Bit concerned about the state of the Fitzy this morning as well.
Oh,
Tim!
What?
I've got some more Polaroids.
Oh, you could get some cream for that.
No, you silly sausage, I mean photographs.
Oh.
I've got a lovely one here, I'd like you to see it. It's from our last holiday in Spain.
Yeah.
It's a really great one, I think you'll like it.
Oh, is that you with the Brazilian?
Yes. It's me and Pele.
Yeah. I believe it's your birthday this week.
Oh, congratulations.
Happy birthday. Are you planning anything this evening?
Well, I don't think I've got a lot on tonight.
Oh,
excellent! We'll come round ours then. Oh. Come and meet Jennifer's brother, Bernard.
Yes,
Bernard?
Do.
What's he like?
He's like Crocodile Dundee, he's at one with nature. Only this morning we left him boning a mackerel.
Would you like a coffee?
No!
Are you sure it's fresh?
No, I'm all right.
It's fresh.
All right. I like fish, so yeah, I'll come round.
That's great.
What on earth is that?
That is a thermos flask.
How does that work,
then? You should know by now. We've done this gag at least six times. It keeps hot things hot and cold things cold.
So, what have you got in it?
Three cups of coffee and a choc ice.
It is a funny joke,
though, isn't it? We've got a nudist colony in Russia to get to, so Moscow.
OK, bye.
See ya.
Bye.
Things I do for comedy. If you'd like to join me again, please. Lovely Rachel. If you want to win this T-shirt in our competition, Feed the Iron Curtain, call us now on 09002444579. Phone now. Back to Hell's Bells.
Cheers, Tim. Think it's time for another break.